Rassie.
Hey.
It's fine here, you know, match week, Ireland. I don't think, you know, there'll ever be another rivalry like we have with the All Blacks, but this is shaping up to be quite a one. How's the feeling?
Yeah, the feeling is like when we play the All Blacks and when we play big teams. I think the rivalry is more from the media side from ours. I think sometimes maybe they don't 100% understand our South African sense of humor while we try to find something funny in anything, even when it's going bad. And sometimes it's quoted out of context. Just like Simon Zito as an example. I mean, the guy phoned me and he says it was in a podcast, an old podcast, having a few beers and we made the crack and he said that. And he said it was, I know I'm repeating myself, but you know, just to take the last part of I say, let's spice it up. That's also that South African humor, saying it back to Simon. You know, so yes, they're number two in the world. They've beaten us last time. We don't see ourselves as underdogs. I don't think they see themselves as underdogs, and I think the C2 team on Saturday are really desperate to perform for the country.
Rossi, in terms of selection, how difficult was it in certain positions like fly-off and other positions?
Yeah, difficult is almost it's almost a bit of a privilege, you know, if you have guys out like Jean Klein and Luit and Hannekom, and there's so many youngsters that we also could have, you know, where the Bulls could have went really deep, that we could have selected Damian Willems and those kind of guys. Yeah, then you go down and you see, okay, but I think is that rugby structure is working in terms of bringing youngsters through. I just look at our 20 captain currently. I think he's probably one of the guys that can play in the next 2-3 years. And they're like, I mean, he's not a loose head, but he's like a little type of player who wants to run it and come through really early. And I think Janine Vessels should have been one of those as well. Look, at the end of the day, they can only play 23. And Ireland is a country that's much smaller than us. Although people like to compare 60 million to 4 million. Not all 60 million play rugby in South Africa, and not all 60 million follow rugby, you know. So, but the way we have depth currently certainly showed us, after all the injuries, that we are on a healthy position, but that means absolutely nothing if it doesn't transfer to the field.
But do you think you guys have got some unfinished business? You are the two-time back-to-back world champions. Is there something to prove against this island side?
I think that they probably, from their side, have unfinished business to try and get number one. You know, so we don't talk like that. We analyze players, we chat on how they perform in the ERC and European Cup. And, we pick our teams accordingly to see what players we think can do the job for us, you know, on Saturday, and we train really hard. And we try to stay in our reality. But our reality is we're playing at home against a team that's beaten us. All the games were really close. They deserved all of those games. But there's never a hell of a score to settle. I mean, I'd rather take a World Cup, two World Cups, and a brilliant Iron Lions series and take the three losses, but we never go out to lose. We definitely didn't dip because team to the travelings. We might still, there's one or two niggles. We might on Thursday still, there's a possibility for 7-1 as well, but that will give time for Thursday, but I don't want to elaborate on that too much now at this point. But Sacha certainly brings something to the party where, he, you know, there's not a lot of changes when we go 6-2. You know, if you had to pick, and that's actually where Marnie missed out, you know, because if a 12 goes down, he can go straight to 12 because he's played 12 for the Stormers. If a 15 goes down, he can go straight to 15. If a 10 goes down, he can go straight to 10. Whereas with Marnie, again, I want to reiterate, for him not making the 23 is just purely because we went 6-2. But Marnie is not so comfortable at 12. Andre would go to 12 and then Manu to 10 or fullback. Then we would have to move Cheslin back to fullback. Everybody from 10, one out. And so that just makes more sense why Sacha can cover those two positions.
And just on the two blocks on the bench, is that because of opposition or specific plan?
No, it's just RG always brings a lot of energy for us off the bench. Someone is like Jan Hendrik Vessel, one of the players. We ranked the players since 2013, what they must work on and what their potential and what their ceiling is. A guy like Salman has just been really unlucky, injury-wise. He always, at very crucial stages just before tournaments, got some bad injuries. He's really showing his willingness and his physicality in training sessions and in a few minutes or 20, 25 minutes. You haven't even know? How many minutes?
20.
Yeah, 21 minutes against Wales when Eben was up. And he had some solid performances there. So yeah, in that sense, it's nice for a front row to have two fresh locks behind them somewhere in the game.
Rassie, just carry.
Yeah, it's a good question. We didn't, but that's not why we picked him. I think Marco brings impact in all the areas, in carrying the ball, in defense, in slowing the ball down, in mauling, in scrumming. He's definitely somebody that you can have on the bench. He can play 8 as well. He's somebody who comes on and doesn't just sort out one department who might not be firing or doing as well as we wanted to at that specific moment. So I'll say he's more all-rounder. Since I can't remember when last we played with an open and blind side, even when I and under defender played left and right. But you are right, he's a great poacher of the ball, and hopefully he can get us a few, but the Irish got tremendous use for it. No, it wasn't tricky. I think Jesse's in top form. I don't think there's anybody that can say Jesse. He's not in outstanding form. In the World Cup he was, in the last World Test match he was. Lukanya hasn't played a lot of rugby in the last 4 or 5 weeks. It's a different story of a guy like Malcolm, where we had him and we could take. We couldn't yet do the things with Lukanya to make him match ready, because he's not 100% match ready. Playing Irish level match ready. A guy like Malcolm, and that's why the last test match was so important. A guy like Malcolm, we could start there, we could give him 45 minutes. Now he can come off the bench again. Bongi can go as long as he can, and Malcolm can hopefully have some impact. But when Lukanya's on form, Lukanya's brilliant, and it's just a matter of time before Lukanya will start pushing Jesse really hard again. And then there's the young Ethan Hooker, who we thought is really fine. We think he's playing well. And then also, obviously, who's our other, Kanan, who really did well at 13. So Kanan will also join us and be available for the second days.
Kwakhan
Evan, yeah. Yeah, if you want to go 6-2 and you want to have Marco and Kwakhan in the team, it would be lovely to have Kwakhan and Marco on the bench since they're going to have an impact. But then you must go 7-1, or you must drop a lockout. We don't feel someone deserves to get dropped out. He's settling in as a nice front lock. He's learning a lot from guys from Eben. Ivan has now been with us for a while. He's got, I think, 4 or 5 test caps under his belt. All of the players out there understand what we're trying to do. We're trying to not kill guys' careers by throwing them into a squad of unknowns around them, but slowly and certainly give guys opportunity against proper teams, and then a bit tougher, and then a bit tougher, and then give you a rest again. And then maybe are you now a proper test player? And I guess you're not sure as he is, and he will get his chance again.
I think
that one is unfortunately just logistics. Like Kovac Reinach had two training sessions with us just because when Montpellier released him. You know, when he's a guy that can easily make the match at 23. But just Krappies was the whole time with us, first, from the first alignment camp, all the training sessions, because we definitely trying some new things, and one or two guys in the team doesn't know all the little things we're trying to do. Sometimes, you know, that swing momentum in the game. Thomas also only joined us very late because he wasn't like Andre Pollard. Leicester fell out, and Andre Pollard immediately joined us, and he trained with us 3 weeks. This is his fourth week, so it's easy to put him in. Thomas, we're happy to have Thomas. We're happy to have Trevor also in the mix. Yeah, and I think Tooks had a really good 10 minutes when he was on. It was tough to leave him out of the group. And then the same with Nettling Fischer and Andre Hofenter, what they brought, not to the game specifically, but to the squad when they were on tour.
Rassie, obviously a lot of these Irish, hello by the way.
Hello, how are you?
A season with Jack Naber in Ireland. Do you have any concerns they might have got a bit extra insight into how the box work?
Yeah, no, definitely they will, without a doubt. But Jacques phones me every night and tells me everything about Ireland. rugby is a professional game, and certainly you will implement things there what worked for us here. Some of them you can clearly see. Some of them are working. Some of them are not working because players and countries and cultures are different, and coaches are different when you're in different cultures and countries. I remember when I was in Munster, you've been out of your comfort zone, and you don't always read body language, and when you said something, you're not quite sure that this guy get what I was trying to say there. But you know, Argus never played for Munster, you know, he's our Leinster boy, you know. What you can nowadays see on television, and if you follow teams on Twitter, they post all their troubles and stuff on Twitter. Nowadays a lot, so you can see who's basically sometimes think who's starting, who's wearing the bib, who's not wearing the bib, and those kind of things. So one thing I promise you, I will never put Jacques in a position where he has his people he's working with and team he loves currently. Which is Leinster. Think he would in any way help us. But I also trust him not to tell him like names of moves and calls and those kind of things. Yeah. I'm not worried about that.
What have you seen? Sorry, just one other one. Have you seen much change in Ireland since the last time? Because obviously Johnny Sexton is gone there, a big leader. Have you seen much change?
The rain's got much easier now. yes, Johnny. I always said when we played against Johnny, he's so frustrated us, but we do nothing to be in his team. I guess I want to say we have respect for how he plays, how he could command games and command respect. But this young fluff he's not scared. He plays it on the game line. You know, he goes for a cross kick if he wants to. He doesn't shy away from tackling. I'm not sure. So put small one from Munster,
Casey
or Murr with them. Maybe Casey, because Casey and him play together. So at that age, you don't feel the pressure of test match rugby so much until you actually realize what you're part of, and sometimes that's good. And what have changed in the game? I think they didn't defend a little bit, jumped in over style, a little bit. And they're out of the line, without a doubt.
Thank you.
I think they're obviously a world-class team. They're good at the structures, they know what they want out of a game. Obviously the last few games haven't gone our way. We're excited for this challenge to test matches in South Africa. obviously I haven't played them in South Africa for the last 8 years, so it's going to be a nice challenge to face them here in front of our home fans. I'm sure there will be a few thousand of Irish fans coming down as well. So you know, it's going to be a great test match.
Should we read something into the fact that Rassie has brought his, so I don't know the English word, the grof is nader for this test match, the series, or at least this test match.
Sorry, the what?
He brought in the grof is the
big guns.
The big guns, there we go.
What big guns?
The Springbok big guns, like yourself and the rest of the squad.
Every time try and pick your best team that's available.
Funny question.
That's not such a serious question. Should we, as the media, as the public, as the supporters, can we read something in there that Rassie and his management team are serious that they should try and get one over Ireland at Loftus this weekend?
We're playing Ireland. I think Rassie's going to always pick his best spot. I think for the Wales game as well. I think we go out. I certainly go out, and everyone who's working on the field go out every test match to go and win. Doesn't matter if that's a game against the Griffins or if it's a big test match or what the final. I think you put on the Springbok jersey, you always want to get a test victory. Goes down in history, that's what we call history, and you want to be part of the better side of history. So yeah, I don't think you can read anything to that. I think Ireland will also pick their best team, so yeah.
Eben, just talking about the...
Yeah, I think there's always... I mean, that's why coaches get paid so much, because they always have great plans and they come with new plans. So there will always be new plans that they'll bring to the game. So we definitely can't expect the same off the board last time. They obviously, they've got a DNA, so do we. So there's always that 80% that will probably stay the same, but there's always that room for change. And yeah, you must just, when you play this match, what are you expecting?
Just on the money thing. Asking who you sold his house to.
Big coach.
Eben, there was much said about the chat you had with Jim and the whole Irish thing after.
Yeah, I would say the Irish media definitely targeted me after that. Of that incident. Look, I said what I said, and it was off the game, and I see a lot of them said up how I could count exactly to that certain amount. I mean, you just obviously give an estimate. It was definitely not less than 6 or 7, was not more than 20 of them. So just gave an estimate, and yeah, I mean, like I said, I said what I said, like, we'll never off the game tell a team, we'll see in the final if there's so many rugby still to be played. Maybe that was their way to say they think we're a good side and we might make it all the way through, I don't know. But yeah, people definitely interpreted that a bit wrong to get a bit out of context.
Guys, there's still 1 or 2 more
this weekend at Loftus, because we saw Leinster coming here, falling short, but then we saw Glasgow Warriors coming here and put one over the boards here.
It depends how fit you are. That's why if you're unfit, which Ireland won't be, you know, they arrive Friday, I think, or more than nine days here, 10 days here. It definitely affects, but all of us, the guys went home this weekend, to Cape Town, 2 days, so they come back to altitude again, when they arrive here on Sunday evening. So, it's more of the kicking. It really has a big effect. It does change your distance and how far you can pass the ball further. You can kick the ball further, you can kick it higher, you can kick for touch further. And you definitely run a little bit more. And that, together with the altitude, because the ball travels so far, and kicking game is quite something currently in test match rugby. But knowing Ireland and coached there for 2 years, they're very scientific around things like that, and they will be doing their best that doesn't affect them.
Last English question.
Actually, another one there that was balanced is trying to hold your job and not get fired in between. Look, if we get all the players to understand, and that's what we're trying to do, the squad we have in bringing players into experience. As I said to you last week, what Andre Yuhu's experience and what Joseph experience, what Tuks has experience, what Eva now has experience, I think it's a much better way of bringing guys in and giving 14, 15 guys, and I'm repeating what I said last week, sorry, but in 2020 we lost the whole year. We just didn't have this, we didn't have this Wales test match where four debutants played and one was man of the match. Now he's comfortable in the Springbok setup. Now if Cheslin goes down or Kanan comes back, there's competition, more competition again. And now Tuks has played well when he came on for those 10 minutes. Now Gerrit is under pressure again. And when Kitsie comes back, then Kitsie must work his way back in. So it's for us, we've got a succession planning chart. And you know, we would love to get so many caps into different players and have targets for that. But momentum and the vibe and the feeling of the fans sometimes overshadow and make you change things, because you don't want the fans and the media start thinking that you're not well planned. And then sometimes you just say, listen, we plan to give a few guys in this game a chance. We're not having great momentum now. Let's throw in the big like Fizzy said. So hopefully that way.
Okay,
you've got 5 minutes left. Yeah, that's van jongeren het ook al die vraag gevra. Dit voel amper vir my of al die druk amper meer raak. Meer games jy kry. Soos Kous Rassie gesê, ek dink jy verstaan meer waar dit gaan, hoe belangrik dit is, hoe groot dit actually is. En as jy begin ouer raak, jy weet, daar is nie nog soveel jare oor jy van elke geleentheid wat jy kan kry. So ek dink, ja, elke toets waar ek deel is, is my baie spesiaal. Ek wil graag altyd deel is van hierdie groep. En natuurlik by my se unie moet misperform om deel te wees van hierdie groep, maar ek dink dis hoekom baie van ons grappie speel is om deel te wees van hierdie span en om saterdag uit te draf in die groene goud. En dis my vroeg gesê, maar op die saak, teen wie jy speel, jy wil uitgaan en jy wil nie so seer teen wie jy speel, maar vir wie jy speel. As jy na die groene goue trui is, dan vir die moment jy alles gee, jy wil van die veld afstap as wenners.
Can I just add something to you? It is actually a little bit tongue-in-cheek, but when the Sharks didn't go through that great run in the beginning of the UFC, we had a camp, I mean, 800 brought to us, I mean,
Yeah.
And you see that, okay, right guys, take up your positions. All the Sharks players went and stand behind the ball. Exactly.
Okay,
so
I
said, I'll have to go.
And I see, I get this nice for the other, but for the other, I'm also seeing Chasing the Sun, the other universities for in the game between Eland and the Arabic, where you have to come in. En die verspeelde kansen wat jy nie gevat het in die wedstrijd in die reaksie. Moes jy enig iets hierdie week doen om hulle te herinner, of denk jy die herinnering van die week is genoeg die huis nie op hy die week?
Ek dink daar is 20 van die ouwens betrokken in die 23. Zie?
Ja.
20 betrokken, so ek dink ek wil hulle herinner. Kijk, vir ons, voor ons was hy nie cutthroat game nie. Het is fantastisch geweest om my laatste mol te score. Maar ek dink die rief hele dreig geblaas. Ek dink wat vir ons die hartseer was, is dat Ierland se mense op een vliegtuig klim 1 uur en als 40,000 van hulle. En ons mense gaan mols toe of township nice been to, of gaan kry daar iemand wat DSTV het, gaan kyk die game daar, en hulle daar absolute support daar, en dit het die mens nogal bieke hartseer gemaakt, nie omdat ons nou gering het, ons is uit, en ons kan nie die wereldbeker wen nie. So die, op die dag, het die land verdien om ons te wen, ons nie goed genoeg palen geskop, en punte gevat, toe ons kon nie, so die rugby deel, is daar, die spelers weer het ons daar gewerk. Maar ons wil bitte graag teruggeer van die mense wat al geloof het nog. nou waar het TV ook al is wat wil dat die sal het of bekostig, want dit maak seker die seerste.
Rassie, Jacob het gister lekker met ons gesels, Jacob Piper. Net van jou perspektief af asseblief, wat wil jy van hom hê na die Wallis-toets en dan wat wil jy graag sien na die Ierland-toets as jy dit review en ook na die reeks, net die reeks wat nou plaasvind, wat is sy rol?
Nee, hy moet vir my kom sê wat hy vir my sien. Hy weet, die eerste ding is hy doen die kommunikasie met World Rugby. So, dis een step up van my af. Wat het gedoen het in die verlede. Hy is baie relevant nog. Hy ken al die referees daar. Hy ken World Rugby se referees manager. Hy ken director of rugby full babies. Maar dit maak het nie makliker nie. Maar hy bring ons baie perspektief klein goedjies wat ons baie keer oefen. Wat hy in een sekere drill sal sê, maar met die drill is dat hierdie bietjie so aanpas, dan beweeg hy nie so in die rooie area, waar die referee jou moeilik in straf daarvoor het. Hy kon al die scrums self op die cadence van die ref te roep in die game. Hy blaas al die oefeningen vir ons, ons is een refiel wat saam, ons doen die videosessies saam, hy is voel aan een deel, en hy elke oogend sê weer sy coaches meetings as ek nie verslaapie. Hy is full-on management member, right? One-on-one die spelers, die ouwens en presses op die neeg is, vat hy en maak seker, wat is die triggers, as die ouwe rak is die bal uit of nie, wanneer is hy 100% uit, want ek denk baie van ons dat hy sê, wonder waar ek hier, maar wanneer mag hy nie neeg gespeel, wanneer mag hy nie neeg gespeel nie, en ek denk ons vir die eerste keer, na hoeveel jaar verstand het nou 100% recht. So, nee, ek bring baie nice, maar hoeveel baie.
Maar
soos
jy in Engels of...
Plusie, en dan hier, en dan kan hy staan soos die op. Sorry.
Maar soos jy in Engels gevraag, en ek raam af, in Engels gevraag met die kans, gebruik jy as aflichter, gebruik jy as span die taal soos vraag, of onafhandelde sake, wat jy hier in Ierland het, en miskien jou antwoord, wat is jy motivering dan ten die eerste span, dan oor die volgende twee toetsen, of selfs die toets, in die tien aan het?
Wees jy, ons verteenwoordig Suid-Afrika, wat die wereldkampioen is, twee keer in die reine. Soos wat Driekus gaan en Gerra, want sy die Comrades aardloop en ons cricketspan gaan, wil jy land trots maak met die effort wat die bevraag sê. Die ouwens aan die ander kant is so'n bietjie van die bijslaag. Want hulle het hulle realiteite waarin hulle groe en hulle sterkpunte en hulle groe wat hulle groe. Ons is aan hierdie kant en ons weet hoe hard ons oefen, hoe ons kies, wat ons doen, hoekom ons het so doen. En ek sê nie, dit is beter as hulle sal nie, maar dan die waarheid die nie meer. Nou, ons draai altijd so nawe as moeilijk aan die waarheid kom met ons dinge en ons sal nooit, ek bedoel, ons hulle nou met twee toetsen wen, het ons dan wraak geneem, het ek dink nie, nee, want ons hulle met twee toetsen gewen. So nee, ons gebruik die woorde soos wraak en die klas op toe.
Laaste vraag vir julle al twee, wat is speciaal om op beloftes te speel, die toets?
Hulle kan. Ja, ek dink ek my eerste drie gedruk op beloftes. Dit is al my nice, dit is bring op in die klantap, in die Vrystaat weg. En nog van Jeza voetbal gekry. Loftus is vir my, obviously Loftus is a crowd wat they get into it. Hulle raak deel van het. Weet jy, in Nieuweland was ook altyd baie keer so gewees, maar jy probeer baie van die mense genie dit net in die baard, maar die mense is selfs die swak doen, dan klim hulle som in jou ook in, en dit lig jy ook som in die publiek. So, nee, ek is, ons is baie op hoog met die Loftus te speel. Daar te oor die boels van laas naweek, maar ja, hierdie Loftus, ek gaan hier spreeslik.
Ja, Loftus vir my ook geloofde stadium, wat ek reis met te speel, ek denk, wat die volkslied sing, hoe hulle ook saam sing, en in die hele ding is ongelooflik, en as dit sy eerste drie gedruk, ek het die eerste keer gehoor, ek sê in een Springbokke span, waar ek klop, ons die bille met op Loftus, ek heb eerst keer gehoord van Springbok span, so ja, Loftus sal altijd special is vir my.
Thank you guys.